Thank you. Now I recognize former member of the committee and permanent visitor to the committee, gentleman from Texas, Mr. Green.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. You're always very gracious to allow me to have this opportunity, and I especially thank you and the ranking member.
I was hoping that with the change of chairman, maybe we wouldn't have you here. But since the new chairman is also from Texas, I guess you're here forever. So.
He and I are great friends. Thank you so much. And Mr. Keating, I do express my sympathies for the victims and my condolences as well. To the members of the panel, thank you for your very thoughtful testimony. I must tell you that I was somewhat impressed, to be quite candid with you, with the way the effort was coordinated around what happened at the marathon. I'm still impressed at how quickly things came together and how we were able to either capture or kill. And I don't like the terminology, but it speaks to what we're capable of doing within a very short period of time, persons who committed a dastardly deed. So I'd like for you, if you would, so that we can just get in the record, some testimony about how successful that coordinated effort was. And I'm willing to start with either person can start, quite candidly, do this.
I think you're right. There was the initial response was very quick. A lot of resources came that were brought to Boston to assist in the investigation from not just from the federal government, but from local police agencies. There were, for example, from our department, detectives from the Joint Terrorism Task Force who were in Boston. There were also other officers from other parts of the police department there. I don't think New York was alone in that regard. There was after a little bit of, you know, whenever something like this happens, it takes a little bit of time to get everything organized. But I think a good sharing of information. The briefings were conducted well so that people were informed of what was going on. I think that was important. There's always, as you know, confusion when these type of things happen. And this was a case which is no different than others. But all in all, I think it was an excellent effort. And it's still ongoing, Congressman. This investigation is not completed. There is still a lot of work to be done. So the need to organize the way you've said, bring all the different actors and parties that have an interest in the case together, to work together, continues to be very important.
Would anyone else like to comment? Yes, Mr. McAllister.
Thank you, sir. In order to adequately address that, I'd like to go back about 10 years, and that is the decade leading up to this tragic event. Since 2002, the Department of Homeland Security, through state preparedness grants, Boston has received about $370 million in order to prepare for such a tragic event, in particular training, equipment, and resources to detect improvised explosive device, prevention, response, and recovery training and equipment. Last year, funding was used in order to speed and improve the efficiency in responding to such an IED threat. Our FEMA has supported 12 exercises and training opportunities over the past several years, eight of which over the past 3 years in areas such as biological attack, hazardous materials, and other types of mass attacks. There's been over 5,500 first responders in the Boston area that have been trained on mass casualty response training and the like. I'd like to just also talk about the fusion centers. The Boston Regional Intelligence Center was there for the preparation of the special event, as well as the dealing with the incident and then the post-incident investigation. They handled everything from video exploitation to look for the culprits responsible for that, geospatial imagery to assist the first line commanders in what was going on the ground. They handled all kinds of requests for information, suspicious activity reporting, seamless updates to those decision makers, not only in the impacted area, but also at the State Emergency Response Center. They worked seamlessly with the State Fusion Center as well and provided accurate and timely information on what was evolving to the National Network of Fusion Centers as well as our federal partners. It really is a model of just a well-performed, although tragic, event in how to share intelligence and information.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I know my time is up, so if others of you, if you'd like to respond, if you would put something in the record, I'll be honored to read it. Thank you. And thank you, Mr. Cole.